Hey guys, Bing here. Here I have a parametric dodecahedron family. So we can change the size, and it's also you can use it like a meshing. So you can change the size to your maybe. Pretend that's a building mass, and then you can create walls or create roofs. Oops, like that. Okay, so let's start. New generic model adaptive. Go to floor plan. And first, place 2 points. So these 2 points and make adaptive. So these 2 points will be used to define this pentagon shape. So like this, because once you know these 2 points, so you can just get the length of this one side, and then you will have the whole shape. So, and then select these 2 points, spline, reference line. Okay, so now it doesn't matter, so you can just place them anywhere. You don't need to be like aligned to any reference plane. So here I prefer to have them like some random place, so it's easier for me to find any issue. Okay, so first we have these 2 points here, and then we need a reporting parameter. So DI dimension, set figure plan, pick on this work plane of this reference line, and then pick this point and this point. So now we have this edge, the length of this edge. Let's call it just call it A, or maybe L, length, and instance reporting, and OK. So now we need to find the other 3 points. So I'm guessing 1 point about here, one's here, and one's here. Okay, so now first let's find this point. So if I'll do a screenshot of this. So if I have this point and this point, and then so the third point will be about here, and if I connect this one, and this one, so this will be 90 degree, and this is L, and this is L, and this angle. So and because the pentagon, the internal, this angle equals I think 108 degree always. Okay, so this one, because this is 90 degrees, and this one will be 18 degrees always. So with this angle, this L, we can get this this offset from this point. So this, we can get this point, so it's offset from this point. So this will be, let's call it X, let's call it Y. X equals L times cosine 18 degrees. Okay, so now let's do it. So I'll first place a point to one face, and on this, so you don't need to be at this point. I don't need to go all the way there. I'll just place here. It's easier for me to pick. So I'll do it in 3D views. Okay, and then place another point. Draw on work plan. Set work plan, and pick the. Just use tab to pick this work plan. See that one. Okay, so tab. And then place it on here, and okay. then you can, so see this arrow means, this means if I drag here, it will be negative. I don't want negative, I drag that way. Just select this one and rotate it for 180 degrees. So go this way and then with a positive offset. So this X offset, this offset is the X. So I'll just create a X instance, okay, and okay. And then, so we have this formula here. So I'll just go family types, X equals L times cosine 18 degree. So now we have this X here, roughly about right. Yep. So now if I go back to this, so Y equals L times, oops, sine 18 degrees. Okay, so go back. The Y will start from this point. So point, draw a work plane, set work plane, and then pick this one. Okay, and then place it on the point, and then select it, go that way, it's positive, and then create this Y parameter. So Y instance, okay, go family type, Y equals L times sine 18 degree. So apply, okay, so now we can select this point and type in Y, so go to this end. Now if I go to top, so if, and then we can connect these two points to create the second edge, right? So I'm going to select this one, so make sure it's one, right? So if I move it, you will see, so it also change this, the location of the third point, which is this one. So select this one point, number one, adaptive point, and then with this one, create spline, and then reference line. Okay, so now we have this second edge. So let me go back to 3D view, or it's actually 3D view. So the next step, is we need to just copy these, okay? Copy these off, and select, hang on, it's a little bit hard to, so pick this point, so this time pick this one, this is a reference point, not the adaptive point, make sure that's a reference point, so on the end of this reference line, so and together with these two points and the CC, just place it here. I'll paste another one here because we will need another one. So and then this one, if I drag, just try this. So see, these two points go with this one. So and select this point, pick new host, and pick on here. Yeah. So this time, the X still is here, which is correct. So this needs to go the other way here. So select, pick this point, change what typing 180. So go this way. And then if click on this one, typing 0. So now we have the full 1, 2, 3 fourth point here, and then we can select the adaptive point 2 with this point connect spline reference line. So we have this the third side. So now we need, so we only need the last point and then create the last two edge. So we have this one, put this little paste here, so select this one, which is, yep, correct, and then pick host, I'll pick it here. Okay, so don't worry too much, it goes up. So and then select this one, and this time I just, let me try 90 degrees, nice, there, and then topping one, So now we have the last point here. And then select this one and also this one, spline, reference line, this one, spline, reference line, and then I'll just drag this to this end. So now we have this pentagon shape. And I'll try if I move the second point. So, yep, works. So let me just create a face so it's easier to. Yep, why? No, something's not right. No, I think it's not quite right. Let's have a look. This point offset, this point offset, this point, here offset, it's not. So this should be Y. Yep, so and also let me check this one offset, this should be Y as well. Now, it's better. So if we move this, you can see this shape go with it. Okay, so now let me try this. Create a new family. I'll create a new generic model adaptive, and I'll load this into this. So we can create a shape. Just use 2 points. So you can do it on vertical places, vertical work plane as well. So let me do this. Okay, so I think I will stop here today, and tomorrow we will finish that families that what's that called?
Dodecahedron.
Dodecahedron. So we will finish that parametric dodecahedron tomorrow. Okay. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.